Hello dear, in this video we are going to discuss about a linear search program. Okay, so linear search algorithm. Linear search is one like we are going to take array as an input and we are going to search for the element one by one. Okay, searching is to check whether the particular node is present in the data structure or not. So that is called searching. And linear searches, as the name denotes, search one by one. Okay, so we are going to take the input as an array size, elements in the array, and the element that you want to search. And output is, if the element is found, we are going to return the location in which the element is found. If not found, we are going to return it as not found message. Okay, so I'll just take and have, I have taken an example. So this is the array that I have taken, starting from 30, 14, 50, 20. So these are all the elements. Okay, so all these things are the elements that are present in the array. When it is array, it is stored in the sequential memory location. So index starts from 0, 1 to 7. So I have 8 elements in the array and the index starts from 0 to 7. And in the memory, I have taken as 100 as a starting address. So 2 bytes of memory is reserved for each and every element. Okay, so 30 takes the position 100 to 101 and it goes on for all the 8 elements. Okay, so this is basic linear search. So here, the number of elements in array is 8 and I have the array. So everything is taken. Now I have to check whether element that you are searching. For example, here the search element that I'm going to search is 20. I'm going to check whether 20 is present in the array or not. If it is not present, I'm going to return it as not found. If it is present, I have to return the position in which the element is found. Okay. So starts from the starting element, linear is starting from the starting. Okay, starting from one, zeroth position, increment, check whether the element is equal to the element you are searching. If it is not, return. Okay, you have to go with the remaining elements. If the element is found, so the element that you are searching over here is 20 and that is found. If the element is found, we have to return, it is found in fourth position. Okay, since index starts from zero, we have to return the position as n plus I plus one. Okay, this element plus one. Okay, so element is found in fourth position. Okay, so now you're going to write an algorithm for it. So you're going to take all the inputs and compare the search element with the array element starting from the first. If the match is found, return the index. If the match is not found, return the not found message. Okay, so now we'll see how to write an algorithm for it. Okay, I have taken an C code for it. Sorry, program for it. I have taken C program. So first I have to include all the standard input output file, standard header file. Okay, and start with main function. Initially, I have to have one variable for storing the number of elements. Okay, since it is going to repeat in loop, I have to have one variable to take the loop count. Okay, so that I have taken it as I. And X is the element that we are going to search for. And we have to have an array, right? To store that array, I have taken A. Okay, everything is of integer data type. And the maximum size for my array, I have declared it as 20. So that is up to the user to declare. Okay, so this is in your C program. It is a structure-oriented program. So all the variables that you're going to use inside the program, it has to be declared first. Okay, so when writing the code, you can start with int and whenever you are using a new variable, add it on. Okay, so now the first step is, I have to get the number of elements, okay, from the user. I have to know what all the number of elements that are present, the array size from the user. Okay, so I can use a printf statement and then scanf statement for getting it. So printf will print the message, enter the number of elements in the array. So user will enter an element and that is scanned. It is of integer type. So scan percentile D and store it in the address of N. Okay, the value that the user enters, it is scanned and it is stored in address of N. And next one is to get the array elements. Okay, so user enter, if my array consists of 5 elements, I have to get what all the 5 elements, right? So to get the n number of elements, I have to run a loop to get it. Okay, since the number of elements is entered by user dynamically, then we don't know how many elements are present. So I have to run a loop as for I is equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. Since index value starts from 0, okay, we are going to scan one one element, store it in the address, store it in address of A of I. Okay, so initially first value will stored in A of 0, second value A of 1, and third value A of 2. And it goes on. Okay, so we got the number of elements in array and all the elements in the array also received. And the next step is to get the element that you're going to search for, and that is stored in X value. Okay, so you can use a printf statement, print enter the element to be searched, and it is scanned. It is of integer data type. One element is typed by the user, and that is stored in address of X. Okay, I'll show how it is reflected in memory too. Okay, so with these steps, we got all the inputs that are needed. Okay, so we got the array. See, we got this array, number of elements in array, array elements along the element you are going to search for. So what you are going to do now, we have to check for that. We have to search whether the element is found or not. So for that, we can use a for loop statement starting from array index actually starts from 0 to n minus 1. Okay, so we can write a statement as for I is equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. What we are going to check for, check whether this A of I equal to the element you are searching for. If it is equal, break it. Okay, or else you are going to iterate it. Okay, so if the element is found, what happened? In between, the loop will be break. Okay, so I value will be less than n. If I value is less than n, then the element is found. We have to return the index value. Or else, if I value is greater than n. Okay, since this loop will be run only for this until the element n is equal, until this I value equal to 7, the loop will be executed. Once it is greater than 7, it will be break, right? So if I value is greater than n, then it means that the element is not found. So we are going to write this in the program. For I is equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. We are going to check whether A of I equal to the element you are searching. If it is equal, break it. Or else, okay, so once after coming out of the loop, if I is less than n, it means that if I value, the loop is actually breaked in between. If I is less than n, we are going to return the element found message. Okay, and the index value is I plus 1. Since index starts from 0, the current position will be added with 1. Else, we are going to print element is not found. Okay, so this is your linear search algorithm. I'll just show you how exactly this will be there, represented in memory. Okay, so the memory address that I'm going to give over here are some random values. Okay, so the memory is allocated dynamically based on the system's requirement, and it goes on. Okay, for an example, I'll just give, this is how it is done. Okay, so in a C program, when the program that we have written is executed, it is executed line by line, starting from main program. So first step is int, it is a declaration statement. So we are going to declare n, I, X, A of 20 of integer data type. So each and every integer value, it takes 2 bytes of memory. So first in memory, n will be allocated with the size 2, and the memory location randomly allocated from 500. I have taken it as 500 to 501. And listen carefully, for a C program, the space is allocated. The data in the space will not be erased. So you have some garbage value here. I have taken it as all nil, but you may have some garbage value in between. Okay, in a declaration statement, it will just allocate free memory space. In that space, some extra garbage value will be there. Okay, we are not bothered about it. So first n is allocated, I is allocated, X is allocated. Okay, all n, I, X. 2 bytes of memory, somewhere randomly in the memory. Okay, and when it is A of 20, it actually means 20 elements of integer data type. So how many space will be needed for it? Each integer element takes 2 bytes of memory. So it is 2 into 20 bytes. Okay, so 40 bytes of space is allocated in the memory before executing the code. Okay, so that is how actually array works. Whenever you are executing a code with the array, a maximum memory location, the maximum memory space will be already given to the array. Okay, so this is why some of them won't prefer for array, since it wastes so much of memory location. And when you exactly know this is the size, we can use it. When it varies dynamically, we can't use array data structure. Okay, so the next statement is, so all A of 0 starts from 100 to 101, it goes on. It is stored in sequential memory location. And the next one is, in the output monitor, you have a printf statement. Enter the number of elements to be entered, and that will be displayed over here. Okay, so what happened? User will enter a value, and this value is of integer type, so that is scanned by the next line. Scan the element, the integer value entered by the user, and store it in address of n. So in the address of n, this two value will be stored. Okay, and the next statement is printf enter the elements. So enter the elements are, like I have given it as only two elements. So 10 and 20 will be entered by user. Initially, starting from I is equal to 0. So I in memory, the data is added as 0. So it scans the first value. Okay, so I is less than n. 0 is less than n. So 0 less than n, and scan the value. So first 10 will be scanned, and it is stored in address of A of I. I value is 0. So in A of 0, the first value is scanned and it is made. Okay, and second value, what happened? I value was incremented to 1. So I value is incremented to 1. And we check I less than n. It is less than n. So scan the value. So next value 20 will be scanned, and it is stored in address of A of I. Okay, so A of I is A of 1. A of 1, the next value is added. Okay, so next I value is incremented to 2. Okay, now we check the condition I less than n. If I is less than n, no. Okay, I is not less than n, it is equal. So when it is equal, it will be come, the loop will be break. Okay, so next statement is printf enter the element to be searched. So user will, so this will be displayed in the output monitor. User will enter a value, an integer value, and that integer value is scanned, and it is stored in address of x. So 20 is stored in address of x. Okay, so inputs and all we have received. And next one is searching technique. So we starts from for I is equal to 0, I less than n, I plus plus. So I value is made as 0. And we are going to check if A of I equal to x. So A of I is A of 0. A of 0 value is 10. And we are going to check 10 is equal to x. X value is 20, it is not equal. Okay, so what we have to do? The loop will be repeated. So when you repeat the loop, I value is incremented to 1, and we check A of I equal to x. So A of 1 is 20, and the element you are searching for x is 20. So it is same. Okay, when it is same, we use break statement. So break statement is used to come out of the loop. Okay, so it has to be used only inside a loop, and the current loop, whichever it is speaking now, that will come out. Like when you're using it in nested loop, one particular loop in which the break statement is used, now that alone it will become, it will come out of that loop alone. Okay. Now we are going to check whether I less than n. So I value is 1 and n value is 2. So I is less than n. So that means that the element is found. Okay. So we are going to print a statement. The element is found in the location percentile d I plus 1. So the element is found in the location 2. I value is 1. So we are going to press, put it as I plus 1, that is 2. Since index starts from 0, okay, one extra position need to be added. Okay, so else, if the element is not found, now then this I value will be greater than n. In that case, not found message will be printed out. So this is how a linear search program will get executed. Okay, so now we'll come to a complexity structure. Okay, so how can you check the complexity of this algorithm? Okay, so complexity, actually it is verified using two categories. One is the loop structure. Okay, like in all the program, like I'll just go back to the program here. So this is the program. So each and every line of statement, it will be executed only for once. Okay, except this for loop. When I write this for loop, this loop actually runs from 0 to n. When I am going to search for an element in an array, in a linear pattern, when the element is not found, that is your worst case complexity. Okay, there are two ways in which a complexity can be represented. One is worst case and another one is best case complexity. Worst case complexity is I have to search all the n element and the element is not found. Okay, since we are going to search it linearly, all the elements need to be searched at least once. Okay, so the complexity in this case, it is order of n. I'll type it here. Complexity for worst case. Complexity worst case is this for loop has to be executed for all n number of time. Okay, to say the result. Like we are not going to bother about the inputs and all there. We are just going to focus on this portion alone. Okay, the portion in which we are going to search for an element. So that actually starts from this place. Okay, so here when the element is not found, all the n number of elements need to be executed once. Okay, so worst case complexity is n and best case is, what is your best case? So best case complexity is something like when the element is found in the first place itself. Best case complexity is when the element that you are searching is found in the first place, how many times the loop will be executed? Only once, right? So that is your best case complexity. So best case complexity is order of one. Okay, worst case complexity for linear search, it is order of n, and best case complexity is order of one. Okay, so make sure like this is an important question for your MCQs when you are having multiple choice question. Okay, so this is very important. What is the best case and worst case complexity of linear search? Okay, thank you so much.